I totally agree. I think that
You want to shout lights?
Hello everybody, this is Priyam from Team Smiley, and today I'm hanging out with the gorgeous Shraddha Kapoor, who is not smiling for some reason.
Am I?
No. Yeah.
No.
Yeah. She is. And Aditya Roy Kapoor, hello.
Hi, I'm smiling.
You are smiling. Thank you very, very much. So before we start talking about the movie, I have to address something which I don't think lots of people have, which is really pissing me off. Your pelvic thrust in Hamma Hamma, like what is
what
happening?
It?
What is happening? Like we are, I don't know if
oh,
you know.
It is happening.
Oh, and
it's happening.
Right?
It's happening.
And we are like an office essentially full of girls. So I remember when the video came out, we were all watching and then it starts, you're like...
Scandalized.
Ye matlab bahut
girl respect. This is an unexpected turn of events.
Like in a very happy way, like not scandalized.
No, I'm happy and happy that you're happy.
Yeah. Did it take preparation or this is just how you move?
This is how I move, man.
Yeah.
You know all those anyway. Yeah, I just the step came naturally to me. Let's just say.
Okay. We are gonna go with that. Okay. So obviously, I mean, there's chatter on social media. You're on social media now.
I'm technically on social media. Well, I am on social media. I'm on Facebook.
Yeah, it's nice of you to join all of us.
Thank you.
Like it's
Thank
2017.
You.
So obviously, there is Okay Kanmani, and there is going to be some comparison because it's a remake. Was there ever a hesitation about this? That how will you match up? I don't know, but like, was there ever a hesitation about signing on or getting on board because there's already a film that's loved so much?
You know, a hesitation not to get on board the film, because I think that once both of us saw it, we loved Okay Kanmani so much that we were like, you know, first of all, we're so happy that we're offered a film like this together. But of course, you know, like with every film, there is any kind of pressure, any kind of expectation is always there. So yeah, it's just, I hope that like, you know, I just hope not to let people down. That's all.
Well, I think the trailer looks very, very nice.
Thank you.
Okay, so I think generally now the films that are working or the films that people like.
Okay, one sec, we'll just shout silence.
Yes,
one,
please.
Two, three. Silence! Yeah.
Very nice.
Okay.
Good job. Okay, so the films that are working or the films that are relating to, everyone wants to see a slice of life, like stuff that we're relating to and all of that. Do you think the era of the great romance is over? Do you think we're out of emotional stories? Do you think we're not relating to over the top characters anymore?
No, I don't think you can. I don't think great, big, epic love stories will ever go out of. Maybe they'll go out of fashion for a while, but I think it's something that that will always remain as long as as love exists. People will want to tell stories that are deep and spanning over time and that are larger than life and that kind of stuff. And people will always connect to it because it's a universal feeling. So maybe it is right now that we felt for a year or two that we haven't had a love story that's connected on that at that level. But I'm sure it's just around the corner. I don't think it'll ever go away.
I completely agree with him. I feel like I really love a good romantic film, you know, with like that full like fairy tale-esque, like, you know,
but
key, that
not,
forever
not
love.
But you've not seen one like, you know,
so it'll come, no?
But I think
it'll come.
I think Aashiqui 2 was in that space.
Yeah.
You know, definitely.
That was definitely in that space.
And I think that our film, Okay Janu, is, I mean, it's, you maybe it's not, you know, that kind of, it's not like a period love story or anything. But I think it's a very, like, exactly, it's more contemporary in a sense. And not to say that, you know, this can't become like, you know, a memorable love story. I think that a good love story can be fit into any time period.
Okay,
I feel.
Which is amazing. Okay, so you've done stuff like Fitur, for example, or even ABCD, which required a lot of prep, like physically in ABCD, for example, or Aashiqui 2, I'm assuming. This is like you guys. This is people that we know in our lives. This is you and I. Is this easier, or is the prepping and knowing what I'm going to do easier?
It's kind of tricky. It's a very tricky. Yeah, I was excited to get a chance to do this genre because in the capacity of a leading man, I don't think I've done a genre like this where it requires you to bring more of your personality to the character, which I think is actually really tricky because to have perspective on your own charm is weird. Like you don't like it depends on how you quantify yourself.
Exactly.
So it's kind of weird. It is, but that's also where the writing comes in, and it depends. You know, it's not. You know, it depends on how it's written and that kind of stuff. But it's trickier. But it's also for me. I found this to be quite liberating. I'll talk only for myself because the last two, three films I've played very particular characters that were supposed to be very different from my own character. So in this one, it was kind of like I felt free and I felt like I can just do what I wanted and a version of me, a younger version of me with a few things, but you're not bound by so many parameters that you have to kind of work within. So it is tricky, but for me, particularly at this stage in my career, it was lovely. Yeah.
Okay. like, and I'm talking you in terms of ABCD I bring up because my God, you're dancing. My God. And even stuff like Heather, which is obviously very different than who you are in real life. And this is closer to reality in that sense. Which one is trickier or tougher?
Some of my friends were extremely like critical and, you know, they say, ki, what were you thinking? Why were you doing that in that film? And who talks like this or whatever, you know, all of that. So I've gotten those kind of reactions as well. So you're right. I feel like this film is probably closer to me in a sense. And I feel like also like the flavor of this film is more conversational and I hope, I mean, that's something that we're hoping that, you know, people feel like, arey yaar, I've experienced something like this, or arey, I speak to my boyfriend like that or my friend like that.
But as an actor, is this easier to pull off than, like, because it's rom-com and it's breezy, than like something intense that will literally, like, you will need months of prep?
I must tell you, it was challenging in its own way, because also sometimes when you've come from films where, you know, you are being dramatic or you're doing something which is like, you know, oh, all of those things, I have to say that Shahad did tell me, you know, just, he's like, chill, just, it's fine, there's no,
he, act too much.
Yeah, or like, it's just how you are, just be that way. But I think also, and he told me, he's like, in actuality, I speak in a very sing-songy way. I think after this film, it's kind of changed the way I speak also. So he was like, you know, just don't smile too much. And he was very clear how he wanted Tara to be. So I hope it comes across well.
It's interesting, like, guideline. Don't smile so much.
Don't smile too much.
Okay, so always about Shraddha and Aditya. The thing is the chemistry, like from Aashiqui to even right now in your promotions. It's obviously very clear that there is a strong friendship. Is there a trick to fake chemistry on screen if you don't like your co-actor?
I think you both are in on it, you all can manage. Yeah, if you're both like, listen, we gotta get this one going somehow. No, I think again the writing helps, you know, the situations that you put in, some situations just bring it about, some don't. But yeah, I think different equations are, you know, you're right, it doesn't always happen, it doesn't always click the same with everyone.
So how do you then manage it if it's not coming across?
That's your job as an actor, to kind of find that, and it's also important to acknowledge that it isn't, if it isn't, and then figure out that, okay, this is not happening. You guys need to either get more comfortable with each other and kind of have to work on it. And it's a job. Yeah, it's not like a perk. It's a requirement. Chemistry in a love story or whichever way it is. Whichever way the chemistry goes. So, yeah.
If I'm not mistaken, I think Shah Rukh Khan was the one who said that I can romance a wall also, or something like that, right? So I think that is a making of a great actor. Like, if you can, you know, do what you have to do despite anything. And that could be anything. It could even be like a situational thing. You're shooting in a very, in like ridiculously cold weather and you still have to like not shiver or something like that. So I think... but what he's saying is also, I agree with that as well. I think it variates as well.
Okay, so both of you, such young, good-looking actors, would you be open to doing roles that are not, say, likable? And I'm not even talking about like villain stuff, like literally like a character who's very selfish or just generally an asshole, or, you know, like something ridiculous like that, which does not relate or does not immediately put you in hero-heroine kind of roles.
But I find those are the characters that are kind of, that people kind of connect with, because they're imperfect. And I think great characters, I just watched Gone with the Wind recently, and I realized how that guy is a bit of an asshole. Yeah. And that's why you like him, because he's flawed and because he isn't perfect and he isn't heroic in every sense, which makes you connect with him, and that's what makes him an interesting character. There's a friction that's formed because of that. So I look forward to finding roles like that, and for people to write stuff like that, because I think that's what makes great characters, when they're imperfect, you know.
Yeah, I agree with him.
But is it never a thing that, you know, like,
it's boring to play the nice guy that's
like
perfect
image,
in every
image way.
No, not at all. Like, for example, I've gotten a lot of, Aashiqui got us a lot of love and this thing, and the guy was a suicidal alcoholic that kind of copped out and whatever, was in the end probably selfish he wasn't there for her in the end. But that made him real, and that made people, endeared him to people, because they could see that vulnerability in themselves, maybe. So I don't think that's the way you should think about it.
Okay, so to all characters, all kinds.
Absolutely.
Okay. And finally, I want to play a little quick little game with you. It's fairly simple.
Yeah.
Okay. The first thing that comes to your mind, I'm going to ask you like a best of and the worst of some situations.
All right.
Okay. So you, are you ready? Are you ready? Ready.
Ready. Ready.
Ready. Ready. Okay. Tell me the best thing about shooting an intimate scene, and the worst thing about it.
Best thing about shooting an intimate scene is probably that you're more often than not your co-actor is quite is an attractive girl, so there's nothing wrong about that.
That's a good answer.
And the worst thing is that
there's no one listening.
Camera isn't rolling. Yeah. And the worst thing is that I guess it's technical, but it needs to be. So they're like, Chin down, and you're trying to like feel it. Yeah, facing. They don't always talk like that. They say like facing. They can say facing or chin down. But yeah, so it's a technical process which isn't really. You don't really get turned on. So maybe that's the worst thing.
Shut the best of the worst.
I like his answers. Can I steal them?
Copy paste. We're going to the
full
thing.
Copy paste. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
The best and the worst thing about being famous.
Ooh, there are many good things and probably many bad things as well. I'll let her go first.
Okay. So you don't copy this time.
Okay. The best thing about being famous is that you're famous and that you get a lot of love and adulation, and you know, you can hear sometimes when people scream out your name and cheer for you and say, "We love you." That's a great feeling. The worst thing about being famous is that maybe...
Who's that? What happened?
Nothing. Can't believe that's Jitu. Jitu's my boy and he's talking way too loud.
Oh.
Hey, Jitu.
What's wrong with Jitu, man?
It's anyway. Okay.
Huh.
Okay.
My boy. For people that don't know what that means...
Okay, the worst thing about being...
Yeah.
I think the worst thing about being famous is probably on a day when you don't want to be famous and if you just want to like be normal and chill and just... Like maybe walk around in Bombay, you can't do that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can't do that.
Okay, the best and worst thing about social media.
You
want to
ask him also
The
same question. Now, best thing and worst thing about
best thing and worst thing about being famous. Best thing is that, yeah, you get love, you get adulation, and people kind of like appreciate you for what you do. Not everyone gets that. You also get preference, I think, at restaurants when you're looking for a table.
Yeah,
they serve you.
The good bone.
Yeah, but sometimes a chef overcompensates and they'll put too much butter and they'll be like, ah! Butter and the chai sometimes is a little too sweet. They put like extra sugar. So that's one. It's good. It's more often than not, it's good. Food is better. The worst thing.
I love it. The best thing about famous is food is better.
Yeah, you lose your anonymity. Like I used to really hang in Bombay and do whatever I wanted. And I was a real road boy. And I don't get to do that stuff anymore. And people say, go abroad and enjoy. But it's like, it's not your own city. And then, you know, I miss just hanging out in my own city and doing stuff that my friends do. I still kind of, I'm still rebellious like that. I still go to places and chill. Sometimes it works out well. Sometimes I'm taking selfies half the night.
The best and worst thing about social media. I would really like for you to answer.
I can only speak about
in
this.
In your 1 week of amazing experience.
Yeah, I'm a veteran now. No, I think you only find out the idiosyncrasies of something if you've been through it. So I haven't been through the whole social media thing. So I haven't been through that experience. But what would I think about it? The worst thing is... I don't think I can answer this question. It's just been a week. Yeah, so I don't know.
Nothing horrible.
Let me find out. Let me,
best and worst about social media.
You can
best
answer
and
this.
Worst thing about social media.
You are really veteran and I think promptly, Miss Harley, your social media game is on point.
Is it on point?
Absolutely.
Thank you, man. Thank you. I feel like the best thing about social media is the direct connection that you get with people, you know, who are interested and people who love you and all of that. And, you know, like, and through your phone, you can just like, have a Twitter chat with everyone once in a while. I think that's nice. The worst thing about social media is that maybe you can get too addicted to it or too, like, you know, like this whole thing also about like, you know, people getting obsessed with their phones and constantly being on the phone and stuff. And I recently saw this very interesting clip about millennials and how we're so like... obsessed with phones. So yeah, I would say that, you know, maintain your distance, don't get too obsessive either. Yeah.
Okay. So as long as it's in moderation.
As long as it's
in moderation.
Anything in moderation. Anything in moderation is good. And finally, best and worst thing about each other. You tell me something about her and you can tell me something about him.
Not three things. One. Okay. Every day we ask. So we have standard answers. Okay, we'll give you them shortly. We'll be giving them to you. We'll go over them or you won't. Best thing about her. She is...
gorgeous.
Oh, that's a new answer. Yeah, she's gorgeous. Lovely. Aww. Done. And the worst thing about her... Gorgeous. Worst thing about her... that she eats really slow, man. She's extremely slow. When we have our lunch breaks together, I'm sat there, I'm waiting, I'm done, and I'm there for half an hour while she's on the second chapati. It's a little tiresome, but... Yeah, that's that.
That's really not a real problem, but okay.
It's a problem when you need a nap after lunch anyway.
Best and worst about Aditya?
Best. He's got lots of best things about him. I think what I really like about him is that
gorgeous.
He is handsome boy.
Handsome,
but that is so there only. But I'll go a little deeper. So I think I like that he's very like chilled out. He's very normal. That's great. And the worst thing, I would say he is very fast. So,
standard, we have standard
things. Yeah. Sorry for repeating.
This is the promotion answer, yeah.
Which is very nice. Hopefully, we'll be able to come up with better round of promotions in your next film. But really looking forward.
My brother is Siddharth. And your bhabhi is Vidya Balan. और उनको देखकर I don't know how much time are you spending with them, but जाहिर है इतना closely related हैं, एक घर में रहते हैं नहीं, I don't know.
नहीं, एक घर में
एक घर में नहीं रहते हैं, but जाहिर
है मिलते हैं, संडे को मिलते हैं लंच के लिए, कभी कभी वो लोग, वो दोनों बहुत बिजी रहते हैं, तो I think yeah, but once a week we try and meet.
तो आपको अपने सामने एक शादीशुदा जोड़ा नजर आ रहा है, उनकी किट पिट, उनकी प्यार मोहब्बत, पेरेंट्स, बट यू नो आजकल की अगर बात करें तो
कुणाल एंड दिस थिंग, तो
तो आपका रेफरेंस क्या है, मतलब क्या सीखते हैं आप उनकी शादीशुदा जिंदगियों से?
एक्चुअली सीखने को बहुत कुछ है. यू आई थिंक दे ऑल टच वुड इन हैप्पी मैरिजेस एंड यू 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 यही सीखने को मिला है कि कोई जल्दी नहीं है. Yeah, like,
कोई जल्दी
it's good for you, but maybe not for me right now.
Right.
Yeah.
और आपकी फैमिली भी काफी influential family हो चुकी है. तीन भाई हैं, एक फिल्में बना रहे हैं, दो फिल्मों में एक्ट कर रहे हैं, एक भाभी हैं जो मतलब लाइक एवरीवेयर ऑटोग्राफ दे दीजिए आप लोग, मतलब घर के बाहर तो गार्ड्स लगे होंगे एकदम 12-13 क्या.
अभी हम फिल्मी फैमिली बन गए हैं, पहले नहीं थे क्योंकि हम सिद्धार्थ हांगकांग में थे 10 साल पहले, वो फिल्म से आई थिंक पहले कनेक्टेड नहीं थे, तो हम तीनों अभी आ गए पिछले आई थिंक 6-7 साल एंड वी आर सडनली नाउ अ फिल्म रिलेटेड फैमिली, तो इट्स न्यू फॉर अस ऑल्सो. मेरे दोस्त जो है माय आई कांट क्लेम कि मैं अभी 24 साल का हूँ, माय फ्रेंड्स यंगर ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, मैं तो आई एम 31 नाउ, तो बट मैं अभी भी करियर ओरिएंटेड हूँ और मैं शादी के बारे में बिल्कुल नहीं सोच रहा हूँ, तो आई थिंक
आपके हिसाब से एक लड़के की शादी की एज क्या होनी चाहिए?
मेरे हिसाब से जब when they think it's the right time,
I don't think वो choose करें,
वो choose करें क्योंकि I don't think कि ऐसा कोई perfect या amazing like the only age is to be young, but of course अगर आपको you know if you won't have kids when you're young and bring them up when you're young, then you should get married I guess when you're younger. अगर वो आपकी priority है, but मैं उस track पे अभी नहीं
पहुँचे हैं, वो सीढ़ी दूर है. आपके हिसाब से?
I have no idea about the future.
No idea. Marriage.
शादी.
अब
इस वक्त अगर आपको उनको प्रपोज करना हो या कोई अच्छी सी बात गुलजार साहब स्टाइल में बोलनी हो कि चांद पुखराज का रात पश्मीने की, तो क्या बोलेंगे?
आपको लगता है कि मुझसे ये हो पाएगा? बिल्कुल नहीं, चांस ही नहीं है. अगर आप एक दो डायलॉग्स लिख के देंगे तो मैं ट्राई कर सकता हूँ.
कोई गाना जो फिल्म का जो बहुत खूबसूरत लिखा गया उसको.
हम्मा हम्मा
हम्मा हम्मा हम्मा.
ओके, लेट्स सिंग दैट सॉन्ग.
अच्छा मैम, चलो जाओ.
रेडी, 1 2 3 गो.
एक हो गए हम और तुम,
हम्मा हम्मा हम्मा,
तोड़ गए निंदे रे
हे हम्मा.
एक हो गए हम और तुम, तोड़ गए निंदेरे, और खन की पायल मस्ती में तो कंगन खनके रे. हम्मा 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 है.
अब भी बहुत अच्छे गाते हैं. यू आर जस्ट स्टॉपिंग योरसेल्फ, यू आर अलाउइंग अस.
ऑलराइट, थैंक यू सो मच एंड ऑल द बेस्ट.
थैंक यू फॉर हैविंग अस.